Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
A capacitor is a way to store electric potential energy in an electric field. For example, this camera flash uses chemical energy stored in this rechargeable battery to move electric charges to a capacitor and store energy in the electric field of the capacitor as electric potential energy. So right now, energy is stored in the capacitor, and I can press this button to convert that electric potential energy to light and heat energy.
Cool.
Did the flash go?
Yeah, everything went white for a second.
The capacitance of a capacitor depends only on the capacitor's physical characteristics. For example, the capacitor's shape and material used to separate the plates of the capacitor. The simplest form of a capacitor is a parallel plate capacitor. The two plates have equal magnitude charges, but opposite sign, and the electric potential energy is stored in the electric field of the capacitor. Capacitance, capital C, is defined as the magnitude of the charge stored on one plate divided by the electric potential difference between the two plates. Capacitance is always positive, which means that capital Q is the charge on the positive plate, or the magnitude of the charge on the negative plate. And delta V is the positive electric potential difference between the two plates. Realize this does mean that the net charge on a capacitor is actually zero. When you sum the charge on the positive plate with the charge on the negative plate, you get zero total charge.
Why are there three lines in the equal sign for the definition of capacitance?
Oh, a three horizontal line equal sign simply means it is a definition. We cannot derive the equation for capacitance because capacitance is just defined as the magnitude of the charge stored on one of the plates of the capacitor divided by the electric potential difference across the capacitor. We pretty much just made it up.
Okay.
If the total charge on a capacitor is zero, then how can it store electric potential energy?
It takes work to separate the charges onto the plates of the capacitor, and that work must put electric potential energy into the system.
Yeah. The law of charges says the positive and negative charges in the capacitor are attracted to one another, so it takes work to move them apart like they are in the capacitor.
Just like it takes work to lift a mass in a gravitational field, and that work adds gravitational potential energy to the mass Earth system, separating positive and negative charges requires work, which adds electric potential energy to the capacitor. Cool!
I thought a capacitor was what made time travel possible.
No, that is a flux capacitor.
Oh.
I bet Gauss is coming back soon, then.
If I were Carl, I'd wait for the pandemic to be over.
Yeah.
Who's Carl?
Johann Carl Friedrich Gauss.
Okay. The units on capacitance are coulombs over volts, which are called farads, for which the symbol is capital F.
Hold up. So the symbol for capacitance is capital C, and capacitance is charge over electric potential difference, and the units for charge are coulombs, capital C. So in one equation, we have capital C, meaning both capacitance and coulombs?
Well, kind of?
I don't like that.
I don't like it either.
Okay, so yeah, I get it. Unfortunately, I cannot do anything about that. If it really bothers you, or you are concerned it might confuse you, you could write Coulomb's name in full for the charge unit to help distinguish. All right. So let's use a disposable camera to demonstrate the basic idea of charging a capacitor. I have removed the outer shell of this disposable camera. You could see this black cylinder right here is the capacitor of the disposable camera. Currently, there is zero charge on either plate of the capacitor and no electric field between the plates. The capacitor is fully discharged. Now, I carefully add the battery to the disposable camera. And I press this button. Trust me, there's a button right there. Press that button. So this closes the circuit to connect the battery to the terminals of the capacitor. And right now, the battery is moving charges from one plate of the capacitor to the other plate of the capacitor, which is converting chemical energy from the battery to electric potential energy in the electric field of the capacitor. Now, the capacitor has as much charge separated between the plates of the capacitor as this battery and circuit will allow. That means the capacitor has electric potential energy because the electric field is there between the plates of the capacitor. There is an electric potential difference between the plates of the capacitor. And in the moment, I'm going to take a metal paperclip and place it across the two terminals of this capacitor. Again, these are the two terminals of the capacitor, and I'm just going to make sure it's fully charged. And I take the metal paperclip and I place it across the two terminals of the capacitor. I love this demo.
I like that.
Okay. One more time, because, you know, the capacitor is fully, the capacitor is now charged, and I place the metal paper clip across the capacitor. Come on.
That looks dangerous.
Nice. That's so much fun. I have converted the electric potential energy stored in the capacitor into light and heat energy. Just so you know, I've burned myself several times doing this demonstration, so I definitely recommend against doing this at home. Please.
I saw it. It looked painful.
Yeah, it actually burned a couple of holes in his finger where he accidentally touched the terminals of the capacitor.
And he said a bad word.
Yeah. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you. What? There we go. Jeez, golly. Okay, now I'm going to take the battery. Ah, God. Oh, take the battery out. Jeez. Don't do this at home. Jeez.